welcome to Madden 17. This is Gorilla Zoe the 4 with Tech and Joysticks. Welcome, my friends. Welcome. And we're just going to dive right into franchise mode. We're gonna get that started. Let's see here. Let's use the crowd there. Alright, start a new franchise. Use active roster.
Welcome to franchise mode. The best way to play through a season right. With your favorite team. In Madden 17, we're giving you more control and more decisions for more impact. Control the game like never before with Play the Moments, the fastest way to play your game. Take all the excitement of the NFL Red Zone channel and mash it into Madden. All the key moments of the game right at your fingertips. Jump into the key 2-minute drives at the end of the half or when your team makes it into the red zone. It's dynamic, it's brand new, and it's the fastest way to play Madden. Now that you have more control of the action on the field, we've added meaningful ways to game plan against your opponent. Carefully selected from your opponent's play call tendencies, install an offensive and defensive game plan that will help you shut down even the strongest of foes. Exploit Sherman's haunted cover 3. Take out Rodgers' deep passing game, or swagger with your own run game.
All right, that's enough. We're importing rosters, it appears.
Select the team you want to join. Don't worry, you'll be able to choose the role you plan in just a second.
Alright, let me make sure I'm streaming here because I feel like I'm not. Broadcast settings. Okay, so I am broadcasting. Okay. Alright, so yeah, we're going to go to... we're gonna go with the 49ers because I'm a diehard 49ers.
If you wish to change roles or adjust options, use the tiles on the right.
Okay. Let's see what we have here. All right. Let's do this. So. We're not, because the first thing I'm doing is firing that guy. Player. So, there's the owner aspect of it, yeah. Manage your coach's team, rebuild your stadium or relocate, set price for everything, so get feedback from there. Then we're going to be the owner. Create owner. Former player, roster happiness. Start with 20 million, lifelong fan. Financial mogul or lifelong fan. So Carter, just like in Formula One, guys, you're going to watch Zoe Carter bring Super Bowls to San Francisco.
Your season starts now.
Let's do it.
They try to box me in, I got my own angles. Yeah, I'ma spend the summer getting to the cake and I'ma wishing put on every candle. I'm like, please, please tell me why you always say. Please tell me why you always say. Please, please tell me why you always say. Please tell me why you always say.
Alright. Simulating the 2016 preseason week 4 starting league. So I hear good things about this Madden.
Your game plan.
We'll see. Okay, install game plan here.
An offensive and defensive game plan has been pre-selected based on your weekly opponent's tendencies. You can change your game plan anytime before starting.
Okay.
Each week you can focus train 3 players for extra experience.
Okay.
It's a good strategy to develop your rookies while they are young.
Okay.
Once you have made your game plan and focus player decisions, choose to start training and head down to the practice field.
Okay. Offensive game plan. Alright, so I'd like to focus on the Buckner because he's a young buck and we want to make sure that he's good. Where's Buckner? Well, first, let's also Colin. And here we're gonna focus on Buckner. And, sure. So we'll do that. We'll start the trainer. We'll start training. Alright. We'll also bring to you Ultimate Team. We'll bring Ultimate Team. We'll bring Player Career. And then Online Play as well. So definitely stay tuned for that. I'm a self-proclaimed good Madden player, but I haven't been playing 16 too much, so we're going to take a little bit of time, we're going to get good over the course of the coming days, and then we'll start some multiplayer. Alright. Alright, let's see what you're talking about, man. Blah, 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 blah. Cover one is a man-to-man defense where the defensive backs line up against an offensive player. Duh. You can recognize cover one by finding that one safety in the deep middle of the field. The 2 cornerbacks will also be aligned around the center. Yes. Blah, 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 blah. Crossing routes and some blah, 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 blah. Okay. Running across the run of the primary says beat cover one. Okay. Pass to the X receiver. Okay. Ooh, that was bad. That was terrible. Let's do that again, huh? Alright. Let's go. Go. I'll take that. There's a cover one. Cover one. When I see if I can move on her, throw the pass. Okay. I like that. I like that. Okay. Let's do it again. Clean. Easy. Easy, but we're gonna do it again because we want 4 out of 4. Let's go. Pass to the X receiver. X receiver, got him. Thank you. Okay. Okay. We're gonna let him do his thing. Blah blah blah. And make your break, and let's go. Gone. I'll take it. I shall take it. Okay. Let's do it again. And gone. And gone. We like it. Thank you, sir. Getting first down against cover one defense. Okay. Ooh, I thought I had that. I'll take that though. Thank you. I'll take that though. Okay. We're gonna restart this one because, well, you know, it is practice. Practice. You just take it as you will, right? If you have a bad practice, you have a bad practice. Whoa, don't like that. Okay. Take that. Silver. I guess we'll go with silver. I like that. That was a clean.
Hey man, listen.
Clean juke.
It's a step in the right direction for you and this team. And as long as you keep moving in the right direction, we're gonna be just fine.
Alright. Too bad he ain't gonna start. But it's alright. Appreciate it. Continue. Excuse me. Alright, so let's get this. Oh, whoa. Prevent first down. I'm on defense. Okay. Get that out of here. Get that out of here. With the mess up. Get out of here. I don't know what they thought, but. Oh, so now I'm locked. Okay. Okay. Bring that down. Get that. Get it out of here. I got that. Ooh, he dropped it. Luckily for me. Out of bounds, I'll take it. I'm getting pretty lucky here. Wow. This isn't looking good, but I'll take it. Prevent the touchdown, okay. Get that out of here. Word? Alright. Interesting. Why am I not? Oh, I see what's going on. They get four downs to get the touchdown. Obviously, like a fucking game. Okay, fair enough. That's bad. Looking pretty ugly out here, huh? Let's go. I'll take that stop. Alright. Get that out of here. Okay. Prevent the touchdown. We're definitely doing this over. I'm sorry. Yeah. Well, no. You know what? We're not doing it over. As I already said, it's just a bad practice. This dude out of here. We got one.
Gentlemen, achieving our goals starts right here on the practice field. I can't stress that enough. You all know we have lofty goals for this season. If you want to achieve those goals, we gotta raise our game. Today just wasn't good enough. So next practice, we have to be much better.
True statement. Alright. All right, we're gonna play preseason game number one for this live stream here. All right, and you're gonna follow me through all the different moves we make, whether it be, you know, coaching changes, quarterbacking changes, you know, whatever changes we make. You know, so definitely, stay tuned. You know,
kick your season off by starting your first game.
All right, play season game. All right, so we're gonna play a season game. No, we're gonna play the full game, 16 minutes. What's that defense? 20 minutes. No, we're gonna play 60 minute experience. I don't even know what they're talking about here. Let's go. Let's go. Let's beat these fools. Let's beat these fools. Alright. Chip Kelly's getting fired the second this game allows me to fire them. Fire him. I'm just not a Chip Kelly fan. I'm a huge Niners fan. And having Chip Kelly as the head coach of the San Francisco 49ers makes me want to jump off a cliff. But that's just me, I guess. Coming from greatness to someone that's already destroyed one franchise is, you know, it's not something you really want to deal with, but we'll see how it goes, man. We'll see how it goes.
Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports.
Yes, it is.
It's opening week in the NFL, and today we have two teams are more than ready to get the season underway. It's the Rams going up against the 49ers.
Is this the LA Rams? Is that right? Yeah.
So let's get out to Santa Clara for the last game of week one, but the first game for our new broadcast team.
All right.
Randy Godden and Charles Davis.
Let's do it.
Larry, and certainly it's an honor to be here on a Monday night as we welcome you inside Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. Tonight, we wrap a busy first week of the season with a second of two on a Monday night between the Los Angeles Rams and the San Francisco 49ers.
That's right.
And once again, this can be called a West Coast battle, partner.
Loving it.
As a matter of fact, that's right.
Able to dust off the memorabilia and get back again together.
We'll let them take the start, but
forget the records right now. Everyone's excited that this game counts that way again.
It's the dawn of a new era for us at EA Sports as the 2016 NFL season is underway. Fairly short kick taken at the 14 here. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line.
Let's go. Okay. Let's do this.
Back after missing nine games last year, here's Carlos Hyde. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
All right, positive. I'll take the positive, positive vibes there.
Shots for the offense, and Carlos Hyde, a talented back,
has taken over as the lead runner. A terrific
talent. That's
kind
of dope.
Can batter you inside, but has
a little
more speed
weird
than what you expect.
That's
kind of
dope.
Distance.
Let's see what we got here. All right, let's do it. I use my tight ends a lot, so you'll see that as we.
It's
a penalty marker. Is it a holding call? Most likely. Of course it is. Of course it is.
Still second down.
Of course it is.
Second down, Gabbard. And he fires one incomplete.
I make bad decisions from time to time.
The intended receiver. And they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long.
All right, let's see what we got. Don't mind me if I go silent, because
I don't think this is the script they had in mind,
you know,
for their opening drive. This is
I'm a Niners fan.
The Rams go nickel here defensively on third.
That.
Third and long for Gabbert. He's going to float this one deep right side.
Picked off.
A clash of bodies here, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And there's a flag on the field. And he'll return this one just shy of midfield to the 49.
Of course. Naturally so.
Charles, I know it's hard when live bullets are flying, but you cannot keep your hand up around the face mask area.
It is absolutely inexcusable nowadays. Right, we talk about target areas all the time. You have to aim lower so that your hand doesn't get involved in the face mask.
And now whistles here and a flag down. Looked like someone got going a little early.
Wow. This is bad, guys. This is a bad start. This is a very bad start. Let's do this again. Let's go. Let's go. That's enough of this bullshit. Let's do it. It matters better. How dare. How dare they. Let's go. Rams no less. Get the fuck out of here. Excuse my language. I apologize. Let's go. Let's go. Let's get this thing going. Let's get this thing going. Let's blitz these fools. Yeah, got me looking a little crazy here. Let's go. Let's go.
On second down, here's Goff. Going for the deep ball. Man, that is Brett for a Rams touchdown.
Okay then, you hang on to that. All right, I thought I had that.
And the Rams are gonna take a first.
Not so much,
lead.
I guess. Right.
And that will go as the first touchdown pass in the career of Jared Goff. He had 43 last year at Cal, and now taking his talents to the NFL.
Yeah, and how about 96 in his career? Three seasons at Cal Berkeley.
Let's go.
37 straight starts.
Now we got to dig out from under a hole.
Didn't have a winning record throughout his time there until his last season. But guess what? This kid is phenomenal. Great footwork, processes quickly, gets the ball out accurately.
All right.
Look out, NFL. Here comes Jared Goff.
All right, let's do this.
The 49ers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. Here's Hyde as they begin on the ground. And he's got Rome.
I'll take that. I'll take that. We like that. We like that a lot.
When we sat with the coaching staff a couple of days ago, they said attacking that defensive look with a run, something they wanted to do, it was effective.
And they were extremely confident, weren't they? Their planning, their preparation, they knew what they were going to get in that defense, and they were able to attack it accordingly.
All right, let's...
And he's just going to throw this one out.
All right, we're going to take this guy out. And apologies for the children. Those are my babies. But yeah, we're going to go Colin Kaepernick.
Bounce here, nowhere to go with it, incomplete.
All right, let's do it.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Kaepernick again here on second and 10. Escaping the pressure right. No, oh, he almost had it. Already with one interception, just missing his second there.
All right, let's
tremendous
go.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception.
So I see how they didn't notice that time, this isn't Colin, really or hands, this isn't Blaine Gabbert. Associating Blaine Gabbert's mistakes with Colin Kaepernick. Go, go, go. Where's the help?
He lost the football.
Oh, my goodness, dude. Why isn't this dude just going out so I can throw it up the field? Oh, my goodness.
All
right, then.
All
right, then.
Able to get it back himself.
Yeah, pounced right back on it. Keeps possession. All right,
then.
So on now is the Clemson man, Bradley Pinion, to punt this one away.
Let's do it.
Deep for the Rams, Tavon Austin. And how about this, a fake? And this is incomplete.
Oh, really?
Gamble, and it does not pay off.
Oh, God.
Unsuccessful. The big fella can't pick it up. It's such a risky play. All right. Fake it.
All right, let's do this.
Here they're going to be the GOAT.
unfortunate, too, because you know they thought they had something there. They don't call it just to call it. They don't just say, oh, what the heck, let's go ahead and fake it here. They feel like they've got something on. They've got the defense in the right
spot. Did he get anything?
Just unsuccessful in that opportunity.
Yep, got a yard. All right.
There, and it'll bring up a second and nine. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here.
A one-yard gain could look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of one-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it.
I'll take that. Good D.
One-yard run. Hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
Good deal. Got to get to the 26 for a first. This is third down.
All right.
Throwing on third. Gone. And he'll just toss it away.
Good defense.
And that brings up
fourth and nine. All right, let's do it.
Third down stop. You don't want to
We needed that. All right, now let's get this back, guys.
They're coming right back at you. That's what we need to do. That's big for the defense.
On the one,
and it's out of bounds. Now we'll see what the side judge says.
All right, I'll take the eight.
At the 8-yard line.
That's fine.
They're the 49ers getting set to trot out there. And this offense last time turned it over when Ford on fourth didn't get it. They're lucky, though, because no points against the team on the board, but we'll see how they respond.
All right.
Yeah, they've got to get a lot of credit to their defensive teammates, don't they? They had their backs on that last series, and because they did so, that allows the coach to still stay aggressive on offense and maybe go for it again in a similar situation.
I was going to say, maybe makes that offense feel good, but when you know you've got a defense making stands like that.
Yeah, that loosened up things a little bit.
There we go. Beautiful. Why is there a flag, dude?
And he does take it in for the touchdown. Oh, my God. On the field, and I don't think this is going to stand.
Yeah, don't put the points on the board just yet.
Oh, my God. What?
So how about that one, Charles? We haven't seen that in a while. The illegal forward pass.
The quarterbacks get so much leeway on this play that you're right, Brandon. It is very rare that we see the call come out for a legal forward pass.
And some secondary help here for the defense in the nickel on third and long. To throw, Kaepernick. And that is incomplete. He was looking there for Bruce Ellington. And that's going to make it fourth down. Here's Bradley Pinion now. And no room for error here as his first punt comes from deep in his own end zone.
Oi.
So a short drop, but he's able to get it out, and this is a good kick. Now Austin. Oh, he slipped right by him.
All right.
Very nice job on the run back there. He'll get 23 yards all time. All
right.
And the Rams are going to start this drive in great field position.
All right. This is bad.
So the Rams in great
to the
position
Rams.
Here as they get things started.
This
They're
is
led
where
onto
I
the field by the former
to.
Cal Bear and the number one all overall
right.
pick
Let's
in 2016,
do this.
Jared Goff.
That's
a tall, angular quarterback who always looks like he could use some additional pounds.
Oh.
He has a great toughness
about him.
Recovered. 37 straight games in college, going back to his first start as a true freshman.
And as a first rounder, a lot of eyes on him, a lot of expectations.
And he has to play well in his rookie year. Those days of coddling guys and bringing them along slowly, those days are long gone. When you're drafted in the first round, they expect you to play right away. And the community's eyes and fan base, they'll be on you the entire way.
They added a lot of talent to a roster that really needed an infusion of youth. Kenny Brand with his second touchdown of this opening quarter. And the Rams That's a heck of a start to this one for him here in the first quarter.
Two receiving touchdowns, just getting the game underway.
Unreal.
Essentially, I mean, there's a long way to go.
This is going to be bad, guys.
This is going to
be very bad.
Because when one guy shreds
very
your team,
bad.
That's demoralizing. Make him spread it around at least.
All right,
he's showing no signs of slowing down.
And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
We got to get something in here. Let's go.
And the Rams defense, they make their way back out there now. They'll be hoping to come up with that same type of effort they had last time when they forced the punt that led to a touchdown.
All right.
That type of effort just continues to carry over. Because once you get it done once, you feel like you can do it again.
And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Picked off by TJ McDonald. And the return will be stopped.
Oh, my goodness, guys. This is embarrassing. This is embarrassing. Now shut up, Charles Davis, whatever your name is. Oh man, we're just getting booed. This is awful. This is awful, guys.
Replicate it. They have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence.
All right, so 14-0 to the LA Rams, which is terrifying to say. But
and he's brought down. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
This is still astounded
by the recovery of Todd Gurley from the knee injury at Georgia, the offensive rookie of the year in his first season.
Now over 1,100 yards, and now you know they drafted the rookie Jared Goff. Kind of see him as their future, but so much of the focus has to be on Gurley this year.
Yeah,
live now to begin the second quarter with Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon. It's the Rams with a football to get us going, and they've got it here with a first down. Now a first down throw. Gone. Trying to lay one up deep.
I'll take it.
As he throws there, incomplete.
I'll take it.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield. But that's okay because the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you've told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit, and they may have to change accordingly.
Second and 10. Goff again. Got his man over the middle. This is quick.
All right. It's good. I'll take it. All right, let's stop him again. We got to score.
Still in search of the first down after that last completion. From the gun on third down, Goff. He finds his man. It's Austin. Still on his feet. And he goes
bad,
down, but not before getting this inside the 25.
So bad. Unreal.
From our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find some spots, and set up and catch the ball. I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down.
I think it's 21-0 in the first half. That's how bad we're looking. Oh, and make no mistake, this is against the computer. I'm ashamed of myself.
Can create his own
absolutely
space
ashamed
and break
of myself.
A tackle along the way.
Now on second down, this is Gurley.
We get it.
And this carry not as productive. He swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. Ian Williams with the tackle.
So after that stop, you know the third down is not a gimme if you're on the offensive team. So what are you going to do? Run it again, or maybe you go play action and try to throw the ball and pick up the necessary yardage.
Third down, they'll run it with Gurley.
I'll take that. That's good D. That's good D. That's good D. That's good D.
And it brings up four.
All right.
So the myth has been shattered. Every cornerback in the league is not just a cover corner. Some of them will stick their nose in there and make plays exactly as we just saw there. A big loss suffered by the offense after that nice tackle.
And Zerline's kick is good.
He's got it.
The lead will grow. It's now 17-0.
17-0.
Stalls out, but they are able to put 3 points on the board.
Yeah, just a yard or two shorter than an extra point. So no problems converting there.
And this will be a touchback. So a first chance here in week one to see the ball be brought out with the new rule to the 25-yard line.
You know what? We're gonna go suggestions at this point. And last time, switch up the play calling.
Interceptions, so this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it.
Word.
I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action.
I think maybe you go play action. catch and show your quarterback, get a little confidence in it, and let him fling another one.
They were ready for what the defense was showing. They had prepared for that look, recognized it, went straight to the air, got the first. Well done.
Love the recognition, because you can prepare for everything. You can watch the tape and put together your game plan, but you still have to understand
right,
what they're doing in terms of what they're
up.
Showing and be able to adjust accordingly, okay. And they did exactly that.
Throwing on first down is Kaepernick. Out to the flat for Hyde. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line.
All right, let's go. Let's go.
And that'll make it a second down.
Let's go.
Off the play fake to Hyde. Here's Kaepernick. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he'll maybe get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that. No gain on the play, and it'll bring up a third down. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. My good friend Charles and I right back okay. at you after this.
Okay. Oh, I didn't want to skip halftime. Oh, wait, never mind. It's not halftime.
A reminder coming up at this and every halftime this season, we'll be checking in with Larry Ridley in Orlando for highlights and analysis of our first half.
I'll take the first time. I'll take the first down. We appreciate it. We appreciate it.
But that almost felt like old-time football there.
Third and two
is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward and got the first down.
What was that? Why?
And they are going to take over right there at the 22-yard line.
And that's now the second time he's picked off a pass here in the first half alone. Again, another great read defensively. And you just see him get in the right position to make the play and get his guys the football back.
After the interception, here's Goff. Wide open receiver complete. And they're going to get this one all the way across the 45. Give him 27 yards that time. And the Rams are going to get a first down.
But that's what you're looking for when you want to
Unreal.
Throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create
All right,
catches.
I'll take the sloppy defense. I'll take that.
Second and 10.
We know it's not
Unreal.
An easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away.
Unreal.
The bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Unreal. Lost.
Back to the air. Goff on second down. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
There we
does
go.
The big boy have the
there
chance?
We go. Yes, he does. Yes, he does. All right.
So this defense clicking early in the year.
Finally, give us something. Good stop. Good stop.
To say they like the early returns.
Here's Phil Dawson now for the point after.
Good stop.
And it's 17-7.
All right. Because the offense sure as hell ain't doing it. Offense sure as hell ain't getting it done.
And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return.
Well, that's a bad kick, huh?
This will be taken about the 12. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Yeah. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles.
Let's go! Green, 39!
On first down, gone. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. It's a gain of 14 there, and it'll be first down.
All right, so they're trying to get more points. Okay. Laughing like they won't get it. But whatever.
So the offense took the timeout. Looks like they're ready to go to resume the action.
Let's do it.
Let's go. Boom.
On first and 10, Goff completes it to Quick. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35.
Unreal.
It's a gain of 24 that time. And that leads
Unreal,
to Los
guys.
Angeles first down.
Unreal, guys. Alright, well, let's do it, I guess, right? Alright, Buckner, show me what you got.
Now a first down throw, gone. Nowhere to go here, he lost the football.
Pick the football up, bro. What do you mean he lost the football?
The one running back is Gurley. The throw on second down is gone. Aaron Lynch in there.
I'll take that. All right. Good D. Good D. Good D. Let's go. Let's turn this thing around. We just needed a quarter. That's all. That's all. Let's turn this around. Let's turn this around. Third and 29. Now what are you going to do? Now what are you going to do?
An extra DB for the 49ers now at third.
Protect that first down.
They go play action with Gurley. Now Goff. He's got time. And he's got his man in stride. Complete. And this time not quite to the 30.
Still low though.
At the 31-yard line.
Still low though.
22 yards on the pickup there. And that'll bring up fourth down. And for the second time tonight, his field goal unit comes out here. He hit his first. Now this one from 48 yards away. And Zerline's kick is good. So yep. We're at halftime here on a Monday night as we send you across the country to Orlando. Standing by there, Larry Ridley with our EA Sports
All right, let's check out the
halftime
report.
Thanks, Brandon. I'm Larry Ridley, and welcome to our EA Halftime Report. The 49ers are behind right now, but the home crowd should give them a boost.
20-7, I think.
Good on the road, and we'll just try to keep the ball rolling in the second half.
Six passing yards versus 169.
So let's take a look at the highlights from the first half.
Unreal.
Rams with the football early in the first. The pass will be completed into coverage, and it's caught for the touchdown. Rams with the early advantage. Rams have it at the 44. Breaks the target on the
Unreal.
Sideline throw, and it's going to be caught for the touchdown. The lead now at 14.
Unreal.
All right, Larry, these two teams back out there as we get
That's
set
a
and
weak
ready for this second half.
Halftime presentation. That's weak as shit.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. Oh, he shifts past him. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line.
It was a good run. Let's see.
And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half.
Unreal.
Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively.
Unreal.
On first down, it's Gurley.
Get back. Get back. And get him out, too. Boom. Boom. Give me that trophy. Boom.
Now Gurley staying down.
I'm booming because that's the name of the trophy.
He's all right.
Understand that. Boom. Get him out of here. Get him out. Don't bring him back either. Season ending is what we're going for. Say what you will. That's what it needs to be. Injured. Todd Gurley. Replacing Trey Mason.
And a first carry of the game here for Trey Mason.
Get that bum out of
here.
Get the bum out.
Alright,
get the bum out of
here.
Alright, let's go. Get this defense. Let's go. Yeah. That's right. Let's go. Where's my man at? Where's my man at?
And defensively, it's a nickel formation here on third down and nine. Throwing on third. Gone. And that is
drop, because you are a bitch.
The intended receiver was Trey Mason.
Excuse my language.
And there's a good opportunity.
Excuse my language. Give me the ball back. Let's go.
And not catching backs.
Let's go. No picks. No nothing. I'm ready to play. Let's do what
and
we
this
can.
This is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it.
All right.
And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback.
Let's go. Defense showed up. Finally. Now can the offense do the second half.
They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance to turn that into points on the offensive end.
Can you imagine what the grease board looks like?
I'll take that.
Because tell me, that's exactly what they printed up.
Let's go.
Stop them on defense, get the ball back for our offense, and let's go downfield and score some points. Now, the last part remains to be seen, but they got the first part done very well.
Do people use grease boards, or you mean the magic marker board?
Yeah, those two.
What's the flag now? Is it holding again?
Holding offense.
You gotta be kidding me, dude. Who is this dude? No, you're no. You don't know. You know better, Kilgore. Come on, bro.
Working from the gun. It's Kaepernick. He shakes it off. And the Rams got it. They bring him down. Michael Brockers. In there,
oh, boy.
With his first sack of 2016.
You know, on these types of plays, we're always looking to assess blame. Okay, where did it break down? Sometimes it's just a great play.
Looking here for Smith downfield.
Good catch. Good catch. Good catch. Excellent. Excellent catch. And you know what? We're going to go out and get ourselves up. Who's challenging, though? I'm not challenged. What is what happened?
I mean, it worked on that
play. Clicked
like
it. I do because I'm not trying. I don't even want to watch this failure.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
Obviously.
Well, he challenged the play. It did not pay off.
And that means he lost a timeout in that challenge.
And as a coach, you hate that. Don't know if you took the advice of the player. You took
yourself. I'll take
yourself,
that. I'll take
that. Your way.
At the end of the day, it all comes back
I'll
to
take
the
that. Good
he
10 yards. Good 10 yards.
Whether to actually challenge the player
good
or not.
10 yards.
In this case, it didn't pay off for him.
And that's got to be so heartbreaking. You throw that flag, you probably feel really confident. And then all of a sudden, boom, you lose the challenge.
All right.
Yeah, when you take a look at it, you're throwing that flag because you believe you're going to be right. And when it comes back the other way, you have to regroup.
And quickly, they get to the line. Now Kaepernick. And oh, not only did he drop it, he dropped it in the end zone.
All right.
But it's not been
that's
the
fine.
Best
let's get it back.
Him,
let's get it back.
Tried to get by with a little help from his friend there. Trying to
let's get it back.
Play.
Let's go back. Let's go.
But you're right. Hasn't been a banner game here in the second half. Just trying to get going.
Big thing is trying to keep confidence up and continue to fire.
What do I do? What do I do? Do I take the three? Take the points,
man. Here's
Phil
Dawson now
points.
With a 49er field goal unit. And this a 39-yard.
And I missed the field goal. And I
and
barely made it.
One-year-old is up and good.
All right. Now we're down.
It's now 20-10. A decent drive there to start the third quarter. They only salvaged three out of it, but they do inch a bit closer.
Yeah, still lots of time to go in this one. Take the points, move on, and let your defense try to get the ball back.
This one taken just inside the 10.
Drop that.
Not a bad
drop
return.
That.
Here he gets it out drop to the 25-yard line.
Get him up. Get him up. Because he's trash. He tried to run it back, but he couldn't do it.
They're out in front last
is
time.
Gurley back.
We'll see if they
is
can
Gurley back.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get
him. Get him out. Get him out.
Ian Williams.
That's what I'm talking about. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Nobody. Nobody was faked out. Let's go. There we go. Now we catch a stride, baby. Let's go. Let's go. The Rams. How dare they? Go up 20 on the field. Uh-oh. Drop him. Stop him. Spit out for a minute. What are we at? Third and three? Let's go. Give me good D. Give me good D.
When the hitch route is
let's
run
go.
Really well, that jab step off the line of scrimmage by
let's
the
go.
Receiver, which is designed to
let's
back
stop
up the em. Defender and give
let's
him a
stop
space. Em. All you want there, get that space, catch the football, and then
ah,
make him pick up
damn.
The yardage
exactly good play. I can't be mad at it. I can't be mad at it. They did what they were supposed to do. All right. Let's go. Runs routes.
It used to be when we were kids.
All right. He'd run so about three I got to get 10 points next quarter. So.
Now you can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
They'll run it now out of the gun. So we got 3 and 1.
We don't believe in you, Mason. We don't believe in you. All right. Don't come out the backfield.
Game can really benefit you. Stayed in bounds there, kept the clock going.
It's what I'm trying to help you understand.
And if you throw the football and it's incomplete.
Ah, God, I can't stop these dudes. It's unreal, man.
Keep in hands of those runners. Keep
skip all of
now here in Santa Clara.
All right.
It's the Rams out in front here. They've got control.
We're
going to
lose this game
as well as we get set for the fourth quarter.
We're going to need to stop him.
Mason.
You're not going anywhere, Mason.
Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what
you're not
doing.
It's not going to happen for you, Mason.
Grinding, keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up in the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Oh. It's complete. It's Brian Quick. And he's brought down after a good game.
Ah, man, nope. It ain't going to happen today, guys.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their
first
defense
game of the season.
Again, we'll see the pistol here.
It will be a loss. I just don't see.
Here's the option going right. And he is going to lose yardage.
The quarterback ever tries something like that. He's supposed to give that ball up. I mean, you don't leave him with the ball. No. That's not what's supposed to happen at all. So I'm supposed to die every time.
Here's Goff now on second down. And the hit jarred loose.
Oh, he dropped it. Good. He dropped. I like that. I like the drop on that. I like that.
And that led to a big drop.
Take him out of field goal range. Out of field goal range. Out of field goal range. That's what I like to see. Stop him. Punt the ball, baby. Take your motherfucking time. Let's go. Alright, that's ours. We cool. We're chilling.
Too much mustard. All right, on that one.
Let's
it hits
go.
A couple yards into the end zone.
Let's
missed
go.
Opportunity there, maybe to pin them back. The 49ers
let's
offense
go,
now. They work their way back onto the field.
All
and
right.
Tough to win games if you're going field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
They're looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder. Puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get 6 and feel a lot more comfortable.
Of course.
He's intercepted. Picked off by TJ McDonald.
Gave it right back. Gave it right back. Gave it right back.
The Rams offense, they worked their way back on the field. They got the lead.
Gave it right back.
What's the key to this drop?
I think it's leverage.
It's over now.
You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer.
What's the flag?
Create space for our runners, and let's go ahead
pass
and get
interference.
These guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
Right.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive.
Oh, God.
Big roughing the passer penalty, Charles, and of course that's 15 yards.
And everyone knows how protected the quarterbacks
are.
Oh,
God.
You got to make sure that when you launch at a quarterback, that you're hitting him in the right spot and in the right time.
Now a play fake here on first down. Looking for the end zone. And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. A great read and it's picked off.
All right.
This is one of the downsides of being a rookie quarterback. You know you're going to get called out about everything you do that goes wrong. Here, maybe he's a little uncertain about where to go with the football. And at this level, uncertainty equals turnovers. And this one winds up being intercepted.
And nearly another interception.
All right.
They've been around the ball all game. Well, so they just got the football on an interception. They almost gave it right back the same way.
And you know, when you look over to the bench after that type of a play, number one is pure relief. Didn't give it up. But it's not the coach you're worried about yelling at you. It's those guys on defense who just intercepted the pass who want a break over there. Hey, take care of the football, man.
And Cap, of course, was a great baseball player, drafted as a pitcher. He kind of showed his arm right there, didn't he?
Yeah, he let that one go, didn't he? That was a catcher putting down the number one signal for the fastball and turning it loose. It was needed in that situation, though. He had to throw a tight spiral and a hard one in order to get it in there for a completion.
And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Throwing on first down is Kaepernick. He's going to launch this thing way down. It's caught inside the 25. And he'll get it down deep into Los Angeles territory. Hyde, the lone man in the backfield. Into the red zone now. Kaepernick flush to his right. Trying to drop one in, but it's incomplete.
I'll take it. I'll take that.
I think that's a big-time play there because the slant route is really hard to cover because the timing is so quick.
Now, we got two timeouts. Oh.
Diagnose it and get to the football.
That challenge screwed me.
Kaepernick will try again on second down. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Charged the ball free and brings up third down.
As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable. Usually an excellent target, and normally catches.
Not today.
To him, but he did not.
Not today.
Kaepernick gonna throw. They almost had another one. They are all over the football in this game. Nearly another pick. Now fourth down.
While an incomplete pass certainly doesn't look like a good play. For the guy throwing it today, as many interceptions he's thrown, he's got to feel a sigh of relief that the ball actually hit the ground and didn't go in the other direction.
And Dawson's kick is good. And that will tighten this one up a bit. Now one score game at 20-13. All right, so you needed two scores to get back in the game. The field goal then maybe not exactly what they wanted, but it's a necessary first step.
Still plenty of time remaining, but you could really use a stop defensively after the kickoff, preferably a three and out.
All right, let's go.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. But now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now in this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. Try to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Give him 8 on the play, and it'll make it a second down. Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this.
All right, guys, what's going to happen? I really don't know.
So it's Rams football here as we get you reset. They've got a second
I
down
really
now
don't
as
know.
They search for a way to get this one Let's to go. The finish line. They come up in an offset eye. Now Mason.
Oh, he got the first.
The line of scrimmage and taken down. Only a yard on the pickup, so from a good situation on second and two, it's now third and one.
All right.
The 49ers going to take another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Third down now following the run.
Let's do it.
They'll run again with Mason.
Stop! Are you fucking kidding me?
Taken down at the 36. They only get two there, but on third and one, that's all they need to keep the drive going.
It's over.
Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. It'll be their third and final timeout. So as they talk things over, we'll step aside. Now they run. It's Mason. Now that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 3.
Unreal.
That's going to go as a loss.
Unreal.
Second down.
Put him down. Jeez.
Don't blink. You might miss something. Certainly apply.
You got to be
defense diagnosed
fucking
the play,
kidding me.
And it was over in a heartbeat.
Really?
He'll get this up to about the 40. It'll be a gain of 5, and it's going to bring up a third and about 7 left.
on a second and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even
guys, and it's over.
They can still run the football and gain enough yardage and to put themselves over. In a good spot on third down.
And that is the game. Ah, what a
week one loss, but it's disappointing. Just week one. Moving forward,
disappointing ending.
Well, the coaching staff's going to go over all the game film. Oh, they'll grade God. Everyone.
I mean, I've got to get better on offense. It's one game. I absolutely have to get better on offense. Well,
and move on in advance.
My offense is terrible.
They get the victory.
We are going to make a move here. We're going to try to anyways for another receiver. Right now we're going to try to make a trade for our number one overall pick for the next maybe the next two seasons.
The players on your team earned XP. Quickly upgrade your team at the end of each game.
All right.
Let's take a minute to see how you can improve your team.
Somebody call the captain, and when they're going to get checks, I always want the fat ones. I'm so I can sing to a chandelier. Yeah, no, we're not gonna make him move for quarterback. No, I don't want any of these guys. Although I do know I need more. Oh, man. Alright, let's see here. Manage my team. Team trade center. We have $48 million in cap. It's long-winded, paper long, and you taking long. You just don't get it. Hung the phone up on Say Tony. Space. Want a song with me. Hotter than Mississippi, the summer of the 1950s. All right, we're going to give up picks. Get pulled over for swerving like high officer. When he asked me why I was swerving, I'm swerving officer. Three.
I can make it bounce by myself. I can make it bounce by myself.
And an 18. One. Okay. I think these are all very good things. I need a wide receiver. Adrian Green would be dope. How old is he? 28. I'll take him if they let it happen.
I shake the ladder. I make her take her and gather and calculate the data. I listen up for the snakes.
Fair enough.
Or the baby rattle. I play the shadows, don't play no games. I straight
good value for draft
pick. Like it's my favorite album.
All right.
Dancer. If I don't get the car first, I have a temper tantrum. I'm innovative. I demonstrated this. Played it. I don't care if you owe me it. You need to pay me. I kiss you later. Kiss you later.
No interest. Okay.
Get keys off table and leave her. I really made it. Get it made. Won't wrestle wrestlers. I spatula all you action figures.
Tiny like a spider on a spud web. I got some on my thumbnail. I feed it to my girls. They say, yeah, yeah.
I'm doing this for the L. When I go, I'm going to leave for the bell. I told you did like a chef. I want a Ferrari in yellow. Just so I can match all my yellow.
And
yellow.
I'm in
elementary. I got my boss in a penitentiary. I got to hang several inches.
I can make it bounce by myself. I can make it bounce by myself.
Word? They accepted that? Okay, so Our first move was to bring Odell Beckham Jr. to the 49ers. Okay. That worked. So... okay. Let's take a look at free agents. Okay, I'm shocked. Wide receivers, we're out there. TJ Jones, never heard of him. And you all suck, so. Okay. Okay. Let's look at the top stories. I want to see if there's any like news on this. To do will advance this week. I mean, that was unexpected, right? I want to see the news. There's got to be league news at this point now. Nope, hold on. We've got to mention it, right? How is there no... mention of this? We've got so much money in cap space, like, I don't... I mean, that... is that not worth it? My stories. I can't believe that. I can't believe that that wasn't newsworthy. All stories. Interesting. I don't like how one of the biggest receivers in the league got no news in the trade. That's weird to me. Alright, well, whatever. That's nuts. That's nuts. Okay. Is it in the transactions? Oh, it's just weird to me. Hey, welcome to the Niners, brother. Let's do it. Alright, I should go get Josh Norman next, but whatever. Man, that offensive line, dude. Oh, God, I need a better line. Oh, my God, I need a better line. Okay, improved team, free agents. Right guard, he's 33, though. Zahari Evans. You know what? Let's fine. All right, we'll take him. We'll take him to.
You have too many players on your team. Choose which players you want to cut.
So he's there. What we'll do is we will cut you, bro. Alright, later. Capping us a starter. We've got Hyde in the backfield. I think that's Jerome Simpson. I don't know. Alright, let's see. Let's try this out. No, I don't want to quit franchise mode. We're just going to do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. Alright, we're 79 now. I don't know if that any better than what we were, but I'm surprised that trade went through. It's worth a number one. I mean, it is worth a number one. So that's fine. So we're going to play this game because, I mean, I've got to play with Odell Beckham on the Niners. So we're gonna play this game, and we'll probably call it a stream, but yeah, who else is as shocked as I am that Odell Beckham that the trade went through? Like, that was odd.
Hello everyone, I'm Larry Ridley, welcome to the NFL on EA Sports.
That was very odd.
It's hard to imagine this not being a fun game to watch.
I'm going to take it, though.
It's the 49ers going up against the Panthers.
Definitely going to take it. Let's.
With that, let's get up to Charlotte, North Carolina.
Let's do what we need to do.
We bring in our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Larry, EA Sports coverage.
I'm going to let it rock just to see if there's any changes to it. Or, you know, if there's mention
of it. It's on to week two, and we've got a good one here between the San Francisco 49ers and the Carolina Panthers. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, and Charles, we look at this Panther ball club as they interplay here. They come in off a good win on the road, and now they hit the home opener at 1-0.
And the offense last week, they had things humming. If you're a defensive player, you may get overshadowed a little bit, but you're really buoyed by what your offense is doing.
On the other side of the field for the visiting 49ers. Right. They were losers their last time out. They're going to try to get back in the win column, but obviously they're going to have to do that in a hostile environment.
And sometimes it actually works to your advantage. Now you've got to band together your team, the us against the world mentality. Let's see if they can use it and get a victory.
Let's go.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Let's go.
See if they stay on the ground for second down.
All right.
On second down, here's Kaepernick. Trying to get it to Beckham, and it's intercepted. It's the safety, Kurt Coleman, and they'll set up shop in enemy territory at the 45-yard line.
Naturally, we're going to say it was a poor pass, but the defensive guys say it was just a great play by them. They broke on the football, picked it off, and gave some momentum to their team.
They'll run. This is Jonathan Stewart, and he's going to be met at about the 43. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
And down to the 36-yard line here. Good work to pick up 7 yards there. That gets him into a third and one situation. Third down and one.
Have they come up with a nickname for just Jonathan Stewart? Remember when it was Double Trouble when he's running with D'Angelo Williams in Carolina? But boy, what a year he had in 2015.
Yeah, it was just 11 yards shy of 1,000, so close, but kind of stepped out of that shadow, didn't he?
Certainly did, and gave the Panthers a real identity running the ball.
So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set.
Third and one, partner. No need to be fancy there. Just use some force and move forward and pick up the first down.
Now Stewart, and he's going to fight his way.
Cam hasn't even thrown yet. That's how bad we are. Or did he throw? No.
Yes.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down.
All right, guys.
You're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Now the Auburn alum, Artis Payne. Scrimmage and driven backwards. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six. In a 3-4 defense there and against the run, a lot of responsibility can fall on that nose tackle.
A ton of responsibility, no pun intended, because they got to deal with not just the center, both guards, and a lot of times they have to eat up double teams in order to let the rest of the guys get to the football. But how about that play? You know, he eat up the double team, he ate up the ball carrier as well.
I was going to say, talking about puns, you said eat up the double team.
And all right. In a lot of ways, that catch is expected. Red zone presence.
All right.
That one was realized there. You've got to find your tight end in that situation.
First down and goal. The offense knocking on the door. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
One thing I know, defensive coaches love it when they don't have to invite their players to the party. This strong safety, you never have to ask him twice to help in run support. He's going to arrive and in a bad mood.
Again, it's Stewart on
second. There we go. Get him out of here.
Play goes nowhere.
Well, you're not going
to. Back to the 15.
All right, brother.
So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down. And the eighth play on this drive coming up.
On goal-to-goal runs, when you create lost yardage plays, the only way that happens is either called pressure or what I like to call straight-ahead pursuit. A great reach.
And he will take it across for a Panthers
touchdown. That's how that goes.
Greg Olsen, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Panthers are going to take a first quarter lead. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. Here comes Bruce Ellington on the return. Now a hit and a loose football. And now this is scooped up by the 49ers.
All right, Jesus.
So a teammate picking him up there, that was nearly disaster.
And the way that you coach these things, you want to make sure you have eyes towards the return guy because you want to make sure that the catch is secured. A lot of teams do that. They have at least one guy. Okay, you're responsible for making sure he secures the catch. He's not always the one that makes the recovery, but he can always sound out the alarm. Hey, ball's on the ground. We've got to get it back.
And he'll get to the 29-yard line brought down there.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
On second down, Hyde. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line.
All right.
They get six on the pickup there as the drive will continue. So the offense has it first and 10. Beckham, the lone receiver, right. Second quarter now. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis with you. It's the 49ers in control of the football, and they've got it here with a first down. They run again with Hyde on first, and he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line. A gain of three, second down.
When we talk about Luke Kuechly, You can't talk about his overall game without talking about his intelligence and how he controls the whole defense. He quarterbacks that defense, and at times will actually make checks, just like a quarterback would on offense to get him into the right defense. They definitely were on that play. How about that finish? Holding that to a minimal game.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. So third and seven and an extra defensive back on the field here.
Definitely want to play coverage here.
To throw is Kaepernick. He finds Beckham complete. And he's brought down after a good gain. A gain of 26 on the third down conversion.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. We heard them talk before the game about utilizing the intermediate passing game this week. It works for them there. They move the chains.
And we saw them work on it in practice as well. And most teams take a period at a time to work on different things. They put a couple periods of work into the intermediate passing game, and now we know exactly why. They got the look that they were seeking, and they were able to take advantage of it. When you call a wide receiver screen, no matter how many blockers you get in front of the guy that catches the ball, there's still an aspect of the guy catching it, turning into a runner, breaking tackles, and creating his own yardage, and he just did on that play.
And he got half of what he needed there, 2 yards, and it'll bring up a third and two more.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands that can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
A 5-yard gain, and now they're set up first and goal.
And fits the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic, so anytime you're a receiver in that area, you're not just focused on catching the football. You're wondering where the collision's going to come from, right?
And oh, his first carry, he loses the ball.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Pardon me, you know how often we hear about the red zone, right? From the 20-yard line going in, that scoring zone, getting points on the board. A lot of teams call from the 10-yard line in the green zone. That's your money zone. He fumbles the ball inside the money zone. You have one job, take care of the ball. That didn't happen.
And Olsen over the middle. Greg Olsen, nobody ahead of him. 20, 10. And he takes it all the way down to the 3. A big play there on the catch and run. 85 yards. And now inside the red zone, the offense.
Unreal.
2 minutes remain here in the first half. Back with more from Charlotte after this. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Larry Ridley will have highlights and analysis of this first half of action. And the offense in a great spot. And he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. Cam Newton with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year. And the Panthers are able to grow their lead. And we certainly know that Cam Newton can do just that. He had 10 rushing touchdowns last year and a nice one there.
And it wouldn't surprise me if one day that number got up to 20 if they so chose, because of his frame. One of the bigger, stronger players in the league, especially at his position. When he carries the ball and gets a full head of steam, you're dealing with a full-grown man.
And this will be a touchback, and as we saw in week one, the new rule, this one coming out to the 25-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And so close to hitting pay dirt last time, fumbling down near the goal line. Now, how does that affect their psyche this time around?
It's a tester, that's for sure, because to be that close and come away with no points is really disappointing, not just for the guys on offense, but the defensive players, too, who thought, hey, we're going to put some points up and have a little momentum going. They got to find a way to just get it out of their minds, let it go.
And now we get a timeout called on the defensive side of the ball by the Panthers. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime.
It's pretty bad.
And the Panthers bring in their nickel set as they try to defend here on third down.
Five defensive backs. Caught left side, it's Beckham. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41.
Well, the advantage has certainly shifted to the defense as we began that third down play, and they found a way to foil it and pick up a first down.
Third time's a charm, right? Two incompletions. Had to have it on third, and they got it.
Yeah, they stuck with it, weren't daunted at all, and picked it up.
Kaepernick again here on second and 10. Flushed out right. And he connects with Vance McDonald. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. On third and long, it's Kaepernick. And he fires one, but incomplete. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively and then just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now. They made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
Yeah, we're going to call timeout.
We're back. The offense had a chance to talk things over. We'll see what they come up with here on this next play. So it looks like the offense isn't going anywhere. They're going to go for it on fourth and seven. They'll come out in the pistol. They do go for it. It's Kaepernick. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. Now the Panthers offense, they get set to come back onto the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
It takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. And the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense is in the red zone.
Okay.
Here's Newton. They'll set up the screen for Stewart. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. Jonathan Stewart, his second touchdown on the season. And the Panthers add on to their lead.
Heard a coach talk about those late in the half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that can finish off a squad.
They got the cushion. This half has been theirs. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he will be brought down here at about the 17-yard line. And San Francisco gets set to go here. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game.
Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And he'll return it to the 24-yard line.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively, getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring
the
out.
The anger
okay,
that I have
with the football, because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
Newton now to throw. He was trying to get it that time to Ted Ginn, and that'll make it second and 10.
How many times do we see an incomplete pass? We just look at the receiver and say, ah. Should have caught that one. That was a drop, and we just put it on the offense. How about a little credit for the defense there? They just forced an incompletion.
Yeah, especially after starting in a tough spot defensively, but a good start there on first down.
That gave them a little extra confidence there, starting, as you said, in a tough spot and being able to make a play on first down. You got to give some credit. They're able to hop up in the air and bat that one away, and that's frustrating for an offensive lineman because the only recourse is when he goes in the air to try and give some type of a pop or a shove, hoping to bring his arms down.
Gets it to Benjamin. It's caught. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. Kelvin Benjamin, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Panthers add on to their lead.
Okay.
And there they got him the ball. Just get it to him. Let him do the rest.
You know, he probably said that to his quarterback as he broke the huddle. I like the play call. Just get it to me. I'll take care of the rest of it.
Helping out his rack, right? RAC.
Run after catch. And he loves that. And he's going to carry that in at contract time.
On the return, here's DeAndre White. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line.
I don't even know what that was.
We get a look at the...
I don't want to look at shit. Alright, I don't want to look at them.
The 49er offense now making their way out onto the field. Now the ball backed way up, so thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball, just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
And now they're in the hurry up. Off the play fake to Hyde. Here's Kaepernick. So we're back in the offense getting set following the call of that timeout. Throwing on first down is Kaepernick. He's going to air one out. And unable to connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete. So it's halftime here in Charlotte. Well, we're going to let you off a little easy there, LR. Halftime interrupted, and we are ready to get to this third quarter.
I like how the announcers are skipping the halftime.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
What was the game?
Out come the Panthers. They'll have it first on offense in the third quarter. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them.
It could just be a first and now thing. I think it is a first
and
now.
And which team has the advantage?
That I'm having, so we're going to continue to make some changes. See who else we can target with the rest of our draft picks. I'm comfortable trading away all draft
picks. That away from them. How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
Yeah, especially since we've got the cap
in. This drive. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game, and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe
blitz coming, and down he goes.
This dude gave that up. He gave that off.
8 yards.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
Okay.
Ellington now to return it. Whoosh. 8 yards on the return following a punt of 41. And the Niners will go on offense, first and 10. Here's a look at the 49ers offense as they make their way out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance really to set the tone here in quarter three.
They can really take charge, can't they? And this is probably how it was drawn up at the half. I think we can go inside the locker room, all right? And I think we would see up on the grease boards, stop them defensively, get the ball back for the offense, and let's go downfield and score. Seems simple, right? The last part, we have to find out if that's going to happen. But the first part worked to perfection. Did exactly what they wanted.
Pass
interference. Offense has to pay it off.
See if they can get the latter 50%.
Pass interference. Defense.
I'll take that. I'll take that call.
So pass interference is partner with all the rule changes. It is hard to be a defender in the pass game.
Brandon is tough in college. It's a lot harder in the NFL. You can't touch him after 5 yards downfield. You can't touch him while the ball's not in the air. You can't touch him at all until the ball is at the receiver's hands. Very difficult to be a defender in today's NFL.
It'll be a 3-yard pickup, and it brings up second and goal.
Tough day. Tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. They try again with Hyde, and the whole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the four. Call it a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Kaepernick going to throw. Vance McDonald, the tight end, was the target. And that will bring up an interesting decision here on fourth and goal.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it.
He dropped the ball.
A big time drop.
Kaepernick, they're going for it on fourth. And it is incomplete. They're turned away on fourth and goal. And this shutout is going to continue as the defense holds again. Carolina getting set to take the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
Now a 10th carry for Jonathan Stewart. And he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line. Just a one-yard pickup there, and it's going to make it third down at 6.
You know how we get focused at end of the half and end of the game situations about how much time's on the board and, you know, what you need to do? Sometimes you don't even have to worry about that. That's just smart football. You know, that kind of a lead, staying in bounds, it burns clock, even in a situation that we're not really focused on.
And here we get a look at Stewart down on the ground still. Hope this isn't anything serious. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. Here's Mike Cyphers now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. Here's Ellington. 40 yards on the punt, 2 on the return, and the offense will come back onto the field for the 1st and 10. The San Francisco offense getting their last-minute instructions before they take over here. And last time, they had it 4th and goal, rolled the dice, didn't get it. Now they've got to put that behind them, try to put together another drive. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. The 2015 Pro Bowler, K'Wan Short, in there to pick up his 2nd sack now of the afternoon. Kaepernick to throw on 2nd down. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
Normally, he's pretty reliable. Usually catches what's thrown to him. On that play, he simply dropped it.
So it's 3rd and long, and defensively, not a real surprise there in the dime. Kaepernick now to throw. He finds Beckham complete. It's a gain of 20 and picking up the first.
I'm about to do a disservice to the catch we just saw. One-handed, coming down with it, just like that. Yeah, I know. Odell Beckham Jr. We're used to this, aren't we?
We are.
And that's just wrong on every level. That was spectacular.
A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's 2nd down. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. They go play action for Hyde. Now Kaepernick. And he's going to be intercepted a 3rd time. A great read, and it's picked off. Then they take possession 2 yards away from midfield at the 48-yard line. Carolina getting set to take the field. And they'll be looking to avoid what happened last time, which is punting the football.
But when you look at how teams play the game, that complementary football comes into play. How do I take care of my defense? How do I take care of my offense? Well, the defense is taking care of them in a lot of ways. Now it's time for the offense to jump things up and help their defense out. Give
all
them
right.
A rest.
Yeah, time for them to give them a rest. Took the words right out of my mouth.
Let's get this crap over
with. We're back now in Charlotte. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number 4. Check. Here's Newton now on second down. He's got time in the pocket. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
Now, he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. Throwing on third down, Newton finding time. And he's going to be taken down here. Back across midfield, 3 yards away from midfield at the 47. Here's Mike Cyphers now as he's on to punt for Carolina. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to have your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
Out on the field now, here come the 49ers. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
Kaepernick will try again on second down. And he drops it incomplete, and their struggles continue here. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. So here we go now, an extra defensive back in there on third and 10. On third and long, it's Kaepernick. Over the middle to Beckham. Now the ball comes loose, and his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line.
Oh, that's the timeout. So what the fuck is this?
It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. And a great spot to start this drive from here. They come out here in the eye. They'll run it with Artis Payne. Give him 3 on first down.
Let's see what happened to old boy. Shoulder tear, so he's gone for a little while.
It'll set up a second and 7. Second down.
At least that makes me happy.
Not a big run on the first play of the drive, but that doesn't necessarily mean it was a bad play. Sometimes you're just trying to settle in, get your guys a little bit of contact, and get things moving.
Here's Artis Payne. Look at the spin.
Balance.
They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh shut it down.
Well, I'd say that run's pretty emblematic of what we've seen all day long. No matter what they've done on offense, this offensive line has controlled the line of scrimmage, giving them time to throw it, run it, do whatever they wanted. That's why there are points up on the board. And right now, the psyche of the offense, we're in control, and we can do whatever we feel like doing out here on the field.
11 yards on the pickup, and the Panthers are set up now with a first and goal.
When a coaching staff sees their team run the ball this successfully in the fourth quarter, they're really excited because you can plan for a running game all you want to press that advantage when you get it. But for the most part, it's a little bit of a surprise. And right now...
And he is in! Touchdown, Carolina! Cameron Artis Payne! His first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Panthers just continue to pour it on.
Well, this game is definitely over, but we do know some people like to go ahead and continue to add to their score, don't we?
Yeah, I don't know that they need to add any more right now, though. I'm just starting to think about those dinner plans tonight, my friend.
Well, you and I will be thinking about dinner plans, but we also know that plenty of people are thinking, how can I get some more scores for my fantasy, forever, other things? They're trying to figure that part out now.
By the way, last weekend we went sushi because that's what you wanted. We're going steak tonight.
I'm in.
All right. And now the 49er offense ready to go and getting back out onto the field.
They made dinner plans over my life.
Turnover, but that turned into 6 points.
They just made dinner plans over my life.
We always hear about empty possessions.
That was disrespectful.
Some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, pump the ball away, get yourself set to play defense. But when you turn it over, it changes momentum. And when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you. Looked like they had an opportunity for a big play across the middle. but he didn't have the concentration or the focus necessary and dropped it before he could haul it in.
We're trying not to get shut out.
Got on third down, Kaepernick. And he's taken down. Back at his own seven. K'Wan Short getting him once again. His third sack of the afternoon.
I remember when I was a kid and all I wanted was a nickel so I could get that soda down at the fountain. And guess what? The nickel came into play.
And from their own end zone, it's a fake. But he will not make the first down marker. That'll be a turnover on downs.
Anytime a fake doesn't work, we usually focus our attention on the guys that were unsuccessful. But how about the defensive guys? They have to plan all week. They have to prepare all week. Special teams, they look like they were educated for that one.
Educated on their toes and getting a... And give them another six. It's caught for a touchdown. And the
Jesus Christ.
And now we've hit that stage of the game, partner, where one of our predecessors, one of the great commentators of all time, he's just singing in this situation when this game appeared to be over.
I know the fat lady's been singing for some time.
No, not her at all. This
but
one of our guys.
Singing too.
Oh, she's singing. She's
on like the fifth tune.
She left scales way behind. But he's just saying something about turning out the lights. The party was over.
Guts fielded in the end zone. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. The Panthers defense, they make their way back out there now. And a great job last time. They got the fourth down stop.
Let's just see if we can
make magic happen twice.
How about the defense, though? You're going to go for it against us on your own side of the field. Rose up and stopped them. Went off the field and said, offense, take over. Put in the end zone for us. That's exactly what they did.
Puts a little chip on their shoulder when that happens, right?
Oh, yeah. A lot of meanness involved in that. And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination. Guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes. The goal of anyone running a curl route is to make sure you try and get defenders on your back and shield them away from the football. But sometimes, even when you run a good route, the defense finds a way to knock it away.
Out to the flat for Hyde. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. Time for a break. So it's 49er football here as we get you reset. They face a third down now as they try to find a late score. To throw is Kaepernick. He's going to let it fly. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now.
They didn't have a ton of yards to pick up on that third down, but there was no way they were playing that one safe. They decided to take that one downtown. They must have felt that they had a big play that was waiting for them. Unfortunately, it was incomplete.
They'll run for it. High. And he has the first down yardage before they bring him down right at the 45.
Oh, man. Fourth down and one, and you're on your own side of midfield? That takes a little bit of courage to pull off. But they went ahead and snapped it, and it'll work out for them as they get the first down.
Eluding the pressure right. Now a desperation throw deep down. This is caught inside the 15. A gain of 35 that time. And the 49ers are set up now with a first and goal. And now a first down following that long gain. Well, even after all those interceptions, he's not deterred, still confident to go deep at work there.
I think all the old rules about playing that position still apply. If things go wrong, you still act like you're the best.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked by the rookie James Bradbury. And a good return here as he takes it up past the 30-yard line.
All right.
And looky there, Charles, just acquired, already making an impact on the defensive side of the football.
Maybe not a superstar, but he does a few things well, and I think they'll emphasize that in his new role with this team.
Here's Artis Payne to begin the drive. And he stopped immediately there. It's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Let me pump out my chest a little bit, even though I'm not rooting for either team. That was a really nice defensive play. It's awfully fun to watch, even in an offensive game.
They'll run again here with Artis Payne. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. Only a yard of the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down. And this looks to probably be the final play.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends.
All right, guys, it's been real. Zill Carter 84. Wow, I don't even know what that is. Gorilla Zill 84. Just got my ass kicked twice. We're gonna make some changes, see what we can do. But thank you for joining us, and this has been our introduction to Madden 17, and God, has it been awful.
Hello, my name is Kamal.
Later, friends.
I am from the clouds. I'm a human. I'm a